Many times we'll have a set of data and we'll want to find one number that best represents this entire data set. We call this a measure of center. Turns out there's actually quite a number of different measures of center. The one we're going to look at in this video is called the midrange. So let me give you an example here. Let's say we had a number of test grades. These are students who took an algebra test, and this is how the class did. We have students that scored very well, like a 99 and a 95. We have students that did not do so well. They had a 65 and a 72, etc. So how do I get one number that best typifies how the class did as a whole? Well, we're talking about the midrange. The midrange is probably one of our most crude measures of center. We simply take the high value and the low value and we average the two. In other words, we add them up and divide by two. So if you look here on my screen here, my low value is 49, my high value is 99. And so to find the midrange, what I'm gonna do is take the 49 plus the 99 and divide that quantity by two. So 49 plus 99 is 148, and divide that by two, and we would get a midrange of 74. So this is the middle of the high and the low value. So some good things and some bad things. The good thing is that this is very quick to apply. It doesn't matter what your middle values are. You just take your low, your high, you average them, and you're done. The downside is the midrange is heavily affected by outliers. If you have one student that scored much, much lower or much, much higher than all the other students, you can see how that's going to greatly affect your midrange. And so if one student, if your lowest student, your weakest student was maybe he missed a week of class and came back and hadn't studied at all and made a 15, well, that's going to greatly affect your midrange. Your midrange will be much lower, and a typical student didn't score in the 50s, right? Clearly here, your typical student seemingly scored in the low 80s or high 70s or so. So as long as you don't have many outliers, the midrange is fine. But when you start to have outliers, you know, you might want to look at another measure of center, possibly like the median or something like that.